Good morning. Welcome to Roda Beats day 6.
No. Good morning. Welcome to Roda Beats day 7.
Like and subscribe. Okay.
Okay, so one last thing that I just wanted to show you, so that's the shop that's in the corner. So this is the back of the pool, so the pool is the other side. So the pool is the other side of that there. So I'm just going to kind of show you all where we are this time. So we are in bungalows, I'm guessing you would call it. I don't know, chalets, bungalows, I don't really know. So this is us, so we're on this run here. And then we walk through here. So this is the front. So we are literally here. We are literally 30 seconds away from the pool. So you go up there and that is the pool entrance, pretty much just there. So that's how close we are to absolutely everything here. So if we go through here, we go through to our room at 412 and walk with me as we go through. Apologies about the sun. Walk through to our room there. Okay, so this is the back. Okay, so again, so one thing that I've never really shown is the archery. So we've got archery there, which I think that happens every single day. So if we just pan back round, there's my room just there. You've got some archery there, and just so that you can get your bearings and you know exactly where we are. If I just go back down this way, so this is the very back of the amphitheatre, which is just there. And don't worry about the amphitheatre because you can barely hear anything of the night. We've been back to our rooms a couple of nights this week, fairly early when entertainment has been going on, and it's been okay. You can hear a few rumblings here and there. And then let's have a look. This is beach volleyball. Beach volleyball setting, and you can see we are practically on the beach now. So I don't know what this is. I've never seen anything happen here. Some sort of stage maybe. I don't know the correct term for this game of bowls of some sort there. And then this is where all of your water sports are, just there as well. There's your gym equipment. There's the amphitheatre there in all its glory. That's where all the entertainment is of an evening. And then as we scroll across, I apologise about this sun. I think it's around about 8 o'clock in the morning. It's incredibly bright and sunny. But here we are on the beach. So as you can see, that's just how close we are. A fantastic setting. That's just how close we are to the beach. Archery, beach volleyball, and then our room literally just there. So we are very, very close to absolutely everything. So we've got the pool and everything one side, and then we've got the beach and everything else the other. And for me, that's not a bad spot to be in, to be fair. I'm going to talk about the rooms a little bit more on the review later on today, but that's not a bad place to be, to be fair. Okay, so I'm just going to take you around some of the water sports there. So there's all your pedalos and so on just there. And then this is where you come to sign up and get all of your equipment. Paddle boards, I think that's what they're called. Paddle boards there, look. They are huge up close. And then you've got canoes, you've got all your life vests there and everything as well. Everything you possibly need. Then you've got little pedalos with slides on it for children as well. And Roda Water Sports is there. Let's just pop round there and I'll just show you the sign. This is some of the stuff that they do. So that one there is Water Sports via the Pirates Bar, which is in Rhoda Town. And then let's have a cheeky look at the amphitheatre as well. So there is the amphitheatre. Me and Dawn normally sit right at the back, right in the middle, just there. So that's where all of your evening entertainment will be. And of course, if this is your thing, this is a close-up of the gym. I see a lot of people use this, to be fair. And then you've got all of your dumbbells and so on there as well. So this is us on our last day here. So there's not really going to be a vlog as such today, because as you saw from yesterday's, it was just nothing but pull down. It's going to be the same again today. We are going to go into the holiday review just at the end there, because I've just got a few things I would like to just kind of point out and say with regards to the Rhoda Beach. So this is our third visit here. Fantastic as always, but I've got a couple of gripes, of course. But yeah, so look out for my holiday review. That's coming up. But what a beautiful setting this is. So thank you. So we're going to see you all very, very soon for the holiday review. Okay, so we've come to that time. So it's the end of the week. The end of the week is always our end of holiday review. So we're going to review basically just how our week has gone. It's gone very, very quick is the first thing I would say. I think that's probably because our first 3 days were completely rained off. It was pretty grim weather for the first 3 days, but we'll get onto that in a minute. For me, the holiday started for me, or should I say one of the highlights started for me, when I was right at Gatwick Airport. So I was on, what's it called?
The shuttle bus.
So I was on the shuttle bus, waiting to go to the aeroplane, and I had my first YouTube subscriber approach me and say, have you got a YouTube channel? I said, yes. He says, we was watching your channel a couple of weeks ago or something like that, you know, which was absolutely fantastic. I got recognised when I was here last year by 3 different people, I think it was. I think the total this year has been 5, which has just been amazing. So the fact that we hadn't even left Gatwick was pretty surreal, that I'm having people kind of recognise me from my YouTube channel. And then as the week has gone on, I've had other people as well who have also recognised me from my channel as well. So, you know, I just want to say to everybody, if you're watching, who's approached me with regards to that, thank you. It really does mean a lot to know that people are watching my content. Not only are they watching it, but they are making big decisions based on the content that we make and actually upload onto my YouTube channel. So it really does mean a lot to me that you guys are approaching me and you're enjoying the content. So thank you very much for that. So on to the week. So it started off, we arrived last Monday to rain. You would have seen it on day one, but I'm just going to leave a little clip right there. Day one. I hope the rain is really coming off, because I've never seen rain like it, to be fair. About what we actually kind of walked into. So we were completely rained in at one stage. At one stage we was right by the creperie and we couldn't move. The rain was just so heavy. We could not move.
Coming down the stair.
Yeah, it was shocking. Now, we knew it was forecast, so we knew it was going to rain. Didn't know it was going to rain that much, but it rained. Okay, that's fine. Tuesday arrived. Wasn't as bad. It wasn't that much better either.
We still went in the pool.
Yeah, we did. We still managed to get an hour or so in the pool. A bit of rain is not going to stop me from doing that. Wednesday, again, was a little bit better than Tuesday. We knew that the better weather was coming from Thursday onwards, but Wednesday, it was still raining on and off for the entire day. By the time Wednesday had finished, we'd had enough, if I'm honest. It had really got to us.
Because get warm.
No, and literally every time we left the apartment, every time we left the restaurant, it was raining and we got wet. You know, and it wasn't what we come to Corfu, Greece for. We understand it happens, it is what it is and all that, but it was getting us down a little bit. Sunshine arrived on Thursday, and in fact, It's been blazing hot sun, 32, 33 degrees, Thursday, Friday, Saturday and Sunday as well. So we can't moan for the weather the latter part of the week, and it's a good job because the beginning part of the week, it was quite tough, to be fair. You know, it's not why you pay an awful lot of money to come away to Greece. I might as well have stayed home in the UK, although...
We all
know how the UK has been in the last week or so. So I think the next thing I just kind of want to mention is the room. So again, you would have seen the room on day one when we first arrived here. Fantastic room. I've done some in-depth coverage of the room, how close we are to the local amenities, such as the swimming pool. I've done a little bit today as well, which showed you how close we are to the gymnasium. They've got an outdoor gym. They've got archery, they've got some bowls, how close we are to the water sports on the beach. We actually emailed and asked for somewhere that was a little bit more central. And in terms of the room, this room wasn't as good as last year. So last year's room was quite a walk away, but it had an amazing private pool. It really was amazing. It was literally at the bottom of our double doors as we opened them. You know, I can't fault that room. It was amazing. So this room has been, it's not been as good in terms of we didn't have a private pool. There's nothing wrong with the room itself. You know, we've never had a bad room. We've never had a bad room at the Rhoda Beach, to be fair. This room was better. It was more convenient. So last year's room had nicer scenery, but this year's room was more convenient. So, you know, would I come to this side of the resort again? Yeah, absolutely, because we are literally...
Sea view.
Literally 30 seconds away from the main pool as well. We're literally a minute's walk from the shop, restaurant, 90 seconds. You know, we are very, very close to absolutely everything here. So a big thumbs up for the room. Can't fault the room. Aircon worked really good. I just want to kind of just squash anything as well. I've heard a few rumours that people have been saying that some of the aircon is €20 a day. It's not. You have to pay a service charge when you first check in, which we've done. How much was that? Was that €28?
€4 a night.
Yeah. So €4 a night, that's it. That's all you pay. So there's no more hidden charges with regards to aircon or anything like that. So the room, fantastic. Let's talk about food. Food as always, right? It's a bit of a mixed bag for me, food. So food here is always good. It's always very, very good, actually. I don't know whether it's been a little bit of a placebo, but I just feel that this year the food hasn't been as... there hasn't been as much variety as what there has been last year and in 2020 when we come. It may well be it's exactly the same, but I don't know. I don't know what it is, but there just wasn't, for me, as much variety. Would you agree with that?
On the main food, yeah. I mean, you've got all your salads. There's so much stuff to choose from, but the main hot food has been very samey.
Yeah, but in terms of the quality of the food, I cannot fault Rhoda Beach Resort for food, to be fair. I can't. It's been amazing. Just want to talk about some of the local stuff as well. So the pool bar, wow. Always wow. Yesterday I decided to do like a menu challenge and I went through every single cocktail that Rhoda Beach could throw at me. I passed with flying colours.
Big mention to Eleni and Sophia, the bar ladies at the beach. They are fantastic.
Yeah, they are.
Pool bar, not beach.
Yeah, to be honest, we're going to talk about people in a minute. We're going to talk about people in a minute, but as Dawna said, they are...
Sorry. They are fantastic.
They are absolutely incredible, as are one or two others here as well.
We'll put a picture of them up.
There you go. Yeah, so we've had some fun, especially with Constantina in the restaurant this week.
World's number one
she's
fan.
One of my biggest fans and she's absolutely awesome, but we're going to get onto people in a minute. But yes, so the pool bar, as always, fantastic. Zero faults there, zero. Creperie, no faults there either. Just as amazing as ever, And the staff who have been serving on the crepery this year have been a lot happier as well. So yeah, I cannot fault the crepery at all. Souvlaki corner, can't fault. Amazing. It's always amazing, but I do think they are missing. I do think they are missing a trick there, and I think that they could have a little bit more variety in that corner. You know, it's fantastic that you can go up there as much as you like and get as much souvlaki as you like, but just imagine if they'd done just a little bit more, even if it was just chips or another type of Greek meat or anything like that. I just feel it would be even better, you know, to be fair. I do think they're missing a trick, would you agree?
Yeah.
You know, but I can't fault it anyway. Let's get on to the people. So people, so as Dawn says, you know, the two girls at the pool bar, awesome. Absolutely awesome. And there was awesome last year, and there was awesome in 2020 as well. So they're always here, and they are always amazing.
So hard.
Absolutely. Photos there. You know who you are. Thank you for making us feel welcome. Thank you for being almost like our friends during our week here as well. Absolutely, I think you're both absolutely fantastic, so thank you. As I say, you know, the people, you know, the people who have served us in the creperie, great as well. Thank you. And Constantina, where do we start with Constantina? Everybody seems to know Constantina on Facebook and other places like that. She's known as the omelette lady. And again, I'm going to leave you some clips or photos or something just here of Constantina as well. But do you know what? She's awesome. I love Constantina. I've had a bit of fun with her. You've seen Constantina. Yeah, absolutely. You've seen Constantina introduced yesterday's video as well. Anwar as well, who I've missed him this year, actually. He's not on Slovakia Corner, so I've missed him this year, but we've managed to see him from 8 o'clock onwards in the main restaurant, and then from 4 o'clock he was in the creperie, wasn't he?
Works very
so hard. Lovely. He really is, you know.
Big smile.
Absolutely. And I'm friends with these people outside of being here, you know, and that's what makes it, that they are all fantastic. And you know what? And they all play a part to making us choose Roda Beach Resort. It really is as simple as that. The people are so amazing, you know. So, you know,
only one person.
So there's like, yeah. So I didn't really want to end with regards to the people on a bad note, but I couldn't help but talk about the fantastic people. But there's one person on this site who, for me, shouldn't work with people. And it's you know, and I'm really sorry to call you out. I don't know her name, but it's a young girl who works in the shop. She works in the shop of a morning, and oh my God, I've never met anybody with a lack of customer service, friendliness. She's incredibly rude. She slams money on the counter. She almost throws your receipt at you. She does not crack a smile. Doesn't have an ounce of manners, and she's a complete contrast to all of the other guys that I've just mentioned. She should not be working with people, and she shouldn't be working with people who help fund the business that she's working for. You know, we are giving these people money, you know, and we're paying a lot of money, we're paying an awful lot of money for the privilege, you know. So the fact that she's just so rude, it's a shame. But she's the only rude person we have actually encountered this year. Even the people in the restaurant of a morning, if you remember last year, I think I complained that some of the morning staff was a bit grumpy. Not really had that this year. The only grumpy person this year is the young girl in the shop. If you are watching this, I'm very sorry, but just smile. That's it. I'm just asking you to smile and just be a bit polite to your customers. So everything else as usual, you know, the entertainment team as well, they've got a slightly new team this year. We've still got some of the old favourites, and they are absolutely awesome as ever. Yeah. Awesome as ever.
But the new fitness guy.
Wow, absolutely amazing. He really gets involved with everybody doing it. He jumps in the pool and he just gets involved. This is with the water aerobics, of course. It's been fantastic.
And the volleyball was in the pool.
Yeah, to be fair, yeah. You know, it's been fantastic fun watching the guys do all these activities. We've not joined in because that would mean us moving off our sunbeds, right? And I've not had many intentions on doing that.
One year,
yeah, exactly. But the pool, again, good and bad, right. It's 95% good. The pool is amazing, right?
Beautiful.
My biggest gripe for the entire thing.
Every time we've been.
Entire resort. Rhoda Beach, I'm sure you're watching this. Please, please, please fix your steps that goes down into the pool. Please. So our favourite spot was literally just in front of the pool. And I think it was Thursday, we probably saw at least 10 people fall over on those steps into the pool. So you've only...
Really bad.
Yeah,
really
shocking. Bad. I mean, I'm surprised they ever broke his back. You know, because you've only got a handrail on the right-hand side. Put a handrail, please, on the left-hand side as well, because what we did notice is as the week went on and a lot more people began to kind of realise what was going on, everybody was using the handrail, but then they was all standing at the handrail, so it made it difficult for the people to get in. But it was quite frightening. In fact, we actually moved our position today. Because it just was not nice to see the amount of people who, not just like a small slip, but they were slipping down on their back. It was quite serious.
I don't know how anyone wasn't seriously hurt.
So, Rhoda Beach, please, please fix your steps. Please put an additional handrail in to your pool, because as amazing as you guys are, that spoils it. Please fix it. Absolutely.
Really.
And also as well, I think the pool of that size, and it's an amazing pool, you know, it's one of the main selling features for us.
Mm. Salt water.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, you know, but I think for the size of the pool as well, have more accessible ways in. You know, that is really the only way into the pool unless you jump in. And not a lot of people like to jump in, you know. There's a lot more elderly people here as well. They ain't going to jump in.
There is a big staircase opposite. But it only goes to the water level and then that's it.
But that's pointless, because on one occasion I witnessed an elderly guy trying to get out of those steps, and he must have been there for 5 minutes and he couldn't get up. And it was a little bit heartbreaking to watch him. All you need there is an additional step inside the water for you to just step on and then pull yourself up. I think the pool itself just needs more bars, just going down into the pool, more steps.
Someone did help him out, by the way.
Yeah, they did. He's not still there. He is out now. But yeah, you know, so please just work on your pool a little bit. On the main set of steps, please get non-slip on there. Please get an extra rail and just put a couple of ladders.
Because on the other side, the smaller pool, there's two staircases.
Yeah.
Two good staircases.
Yeah. So that's my biggest gripe. If I could only fix one, and that's the lady in the shop or the pool, I'd fix the pool.
Yeah.
I'd rather get served by somebody as grumpy as her, but make sure that everybody else is safe getting in and out of the pool. It was that bad. It was pretty horrific. So, you know, please, Rhoda Beach, fix it. Anyway, that's it. I think our time this year has gone very, very quick because we lost the first 3 days to rain. So we've only had 4 days of sunshine, which has been amazing, and we've made the most of it.
You managed to burn yourself, so.
Yeah, look.
The back's the worst.
Always. I'm not going to go into detail about what we've done outside of the resort, because you would have seen those on the previous vlogs. But that's it. So one thing as well that I do want to say is that I'm not filming or I'm not recording a going home vlog. So there's no more days after this. This is it. Purely because... People are tuning in to this series to see Rhoda Beach, to see Corfu. They're not tuning in to see us go home. So I'm not filming a going home vlog this year. There's no point, to be fair. It done all right last year when I filmed it, but I just don't see the point. So this is going to be us signing off for our holiday this year completely. You know, and as always, going back to the people who have recognised me from YouTube, thank you. It really does mean... I mean, I don't do YouTube to get famous, but wow.
Putting pictures in of Marina and Vern.
Yeah, we'll do that. I think I've done that in the previous video anyway when we first met. But we met a fantastic couple, Marina and Vernon. If I didn't put it in there, there's your photo there. Thank you again for approaching us, just being so lovely, being so friendly. Absolutely fantastic, thank you. So that's going to bring our holiday to a close. Now, I hope you've enjoyed watching our holiday memories. I really do. It's been yet another awesome week. And I just want to say thank you, you know. Thank you so much for tuning in to all of the vlogs. Thank you for all of your comments. Please subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. Where have you been? Please give the video or the videos a thumbs up if you've enjoyed all of the content. Thank you all so much for watching. And next year, I'm not going to tell you where we're going. Thank you all so much for watching, and we're going to see you next year. Thanks for watching. Bye. Go.
Thank you very much.
So we're going home now. I know we said that we weren't going to vlog anymore, but I just had to do this. Okay, but there's a couple of bits just as we was leaving. Constantina, fantastic, what an amazing person. She's made me a little paper rose, which is just so cute, and she made me a finished balloon as well, so you're going to see that as soon as I'm done. But what a marvellous person she is. She's absolutely lovely. She's just so friendly, and it really helps make your stay worthwhile. So Constantina, from myself and Dawn, thank you so much.
And if you're coming here, please pop up to her and say hello, and say Dawn and Mel told you to say hello.
Absolutely. Thank you so much for making us feel so welcome. You are truly a fantastic person. Thank you very much, and I'm gonna see you very, very soon.
You say you love me. You say you care, and when you're with me, my future's there. We get carried away in emotion, we get lost in each other's eyes, and we forget what we regret as we cast our fears aside. When the world's getting hard, I will go to wherever you are. Running blind in the dark, I will go to wherever you are. Wherever you are, that's where I'll be. Wherever you are, that's where I'll be. Forget the violence, forget the world. I see you smiling, I'm lost for words. We get carried away in emotion, we get lost in each other's eyes, and we forget what we regret as we cast our fears aside. When the world's getting high, I will go to wherever.
I'm still going.
No. Welcome to Roda Beats. day 6.
Good morning. Welcome to Roda Beach. Day 7. No, no, no.
Oh, yeah.
This is not going well.
One more time. Yeah. One.
I love that.
Okay, it's
that's
okay.
Brilliant.
It's.
Right, stay there, stay there. Perfect. Love it. You're very creative.
I'm trying. No need to put any sound on it.
No, I can have some music going over it.
That's where I'll be. Wherever you are, that's where I'll be.